What's up, everyone? I'm here with day 21 of using Dainichi XL Pro. I don't have too much more to say about the food that I haven't already said. Everything that it said it would do, it is doing with regards to sharpening up blues, greens, and yellows, as well as promoting growth. A lot of my juveniles have showed up a lot of nice growth in the last couple weeks. I'm so sorry for my voice. I've had a cold all week, so I apologize for that. But I mean, even the front, the calvis, I thought I saw some back there. There's calvis there somewhere. They're there. They've put on a nice little bit of size in the last little while. So it's exciting to watch. Not in a rush to see the fish grow up fast or anything, but it's just nice to see them growing. But yeah, so I don't have too much to say in the video. I did want to share some information. I had a couple emails back and forth with the Dainichi company. I was asking a few questions that they were kind enough to answer for me, so I thought I would put that information into this video as well. It was actually regarding the protein levels that I was asking them about. So they wrote me back that they are willing to vouch for the safety of this food on even fish such as Trophius. So I thought that was pretty, amazing for them to actually put in writing that they would vouch for it, because, Trophius are very, finicky. Their digestive systems are very tricky. They're very prone to bloat. They said that they tested the color effects for months on Trophius and had like amazing results. The color effects being one of their higher protein levels. I think it's 44 or 45%. Their veggie effects, which is for their herbivore formula, actually is at 38 or 39% range, which is still higher than the regular NLS. So they're saying it's safe, to feed the fish, and they're actually saying that it's not the protein levels that I should be worried about. I'm just going to read you guys exactly what they wrote to me here. 44 to 45% protein is not as much a risk as the starch binders in low protein foods. It is the swelling of the starch in the cichlid's gut that causes blockage or bloat in the fish. So they're actually warning me. They're like, beware of lower protein food, because apparently the binders is what I'll be having issues with. They were saying that they would be interested to see what my fish would look like if I fed them more than a pinch daily. I'm actually going to go ahead and do that because I'm curious to know what they would look like if I fed it to them a little bit more. I'm thinking of skipping days of feeding New Life Spectrum and going ahead and doubling up on the Dainichi. So this might be my last video for XL Pro, but I'm probably going to do like a review or an update on my fish with what's been going on with them, with their Dainichi diet being doubled. Maybe not double, but at least 50% more. I'm going to give it a try. I'm very, wary of what I feed my fish or how much I feed them. Just, I love them. I put a lot of time and effort into the hobby. A lot of people that watch these videos, you guys are really into the hobby, and you know how it is. You just don't want to risk their health. But these are looking fabulous, eh? Like, the blues are just phenomenal. My camera's crap, so you can never really see. But in person, it's just a fantastic. The fish look great. But, I thought it was nice of Dainichi to take the time to, write that back to me. They're actually also willing to help me out with a contest I was going to be doing. When I hit 100 subscribers, I'm probably going to do a video contest. Any suggestions on what the video entry should actually be on would be greatly appreciated. Oh, look, that's my little... I got this speckle this week. Having a little bit of a brown algae problem. So I'm probably going to do a contest when I hit 100. You guys, if you want to shoot me some comments or emails of suggestions, what you think the video entries should be. But the prize will be Dainichi food. I'm probably going to pick up a few bags of color effects and veggie effects as the prizes. Dainichi is willing to pay the shipping of that prize to said winner. So, wherever you guys are in the world, you're all eligible to enter. I will have all the details ready when I get closer to 100. But I'm coming closer. Everyone that's been subscribing and liking, that's awesome. Thanks so much. You guys can also follow me on Instagram at sinsal09. It's C-I-N-S-A-L-09. Speaking of Instagram, I had a lot of people were doing shout-outs this week, so I thought I would do a few as well at the back of this video. There's a lot of awesome people on Instagram. I don't know how many of my YouTube watchers are on Instagram, but there's really amazing people, a lot of knowledge, really, really fabulous pictures to look at. So I'll just shout out some names now of some of the guys that I talked to. You know, there's Convict2161. I think he's a chief crazy guy, I think he is, on YouTube. I should have wrote it down. But he's got some really great information. Gabby Mazer, Big Munoz. I think he's Big Munoz 11, if I'm not mistaken, on YouTube. Following Ivy, it's my girl. There's not a lot of girls out there in this hobby. And if they are, I don't know why you guys aren't on my friend list. But it's nice to see other females in the hobby. That Seth guy with the fish, fellow Canadian. He actually picked up some Frontosa from some of these from the same clutch. So we're like practically family, me and Seth, whether he likes it or not. From Canada as well with me. Cichlid Man Lou 9294. Gosh, there's so many. Rizzo, the fish guy, ODS 516. Nico, Baz, Jay Wilson. Cichlids and Shit, Trucks for Fish, Cisco, it's just a bunch. If I've forgotten anyone, I'm so sorry. There's just a ton of really great people on Instagram. So, you know, if you're on Instagram, go find them, like their pictures, follow them. Fantastic, really fantastic pictures. Oh, Fish Stud, absolutely amazing pictures on his Instagram. So yeah, that's my video for this week, guys. Sorry, it's a little bit long again this week, I apologize, but thanks for sitting through it, and I'll check you guys out probably in another week. Thanks again for everyone that's subscribing, and you guys have a fantastic week. Alright, talk to you guys soon. Bye.